Good day, everyone. I believe you are doing well at your homes. So, in our last class, we were discussing energy quantization, and we are made to understand that energy quantization refers to that fixed amount of energy that is being emitted when an electron jumps from an excited state to a ground state. A photon of energy is always emitted. So that process is what we call the energy quantization. So today we are going to continue our discussions on energy quantization with a subtopic, the photoelectric effect. A photoelectric effect is the emission of an electron on the metallic surface when a light ray fell on it. This phenomenon was discovered by a man called Leonard somewhere in 1902. In his research, he discovered that when a light ray falls on a photocell, which is made up of a metal, he discovered that when he increased the intensity of the light, the electrons that are being emitted from that metal is independent on how strong or how weak the light ray is. So, increasing the intensity of the light only increases the number of electrons that are emitted on the surface of the metal. So, after his research, he came up with a graph in which he plotted the value of kinetic energy of the electrons that are being emitted on the surface of the metal against the frequency of the light rays that fall on the metal. So this is the nature of his graph. This is the kinetic energy. This is the frequency of the light rays that fall on it. So from point K to O, this from point K to O refers to what we call the work function, while from point O to F naught, we refer to that one as the threshold frequency. So, at the end of his research, he discovered that the kinetic energy of any electrons that being emitted on the surface of a metal depends directly on the frequency or the wavelength of the light rays that fall on it. So, Albert Einstein also worked on the photoelectric effect, and it's been given by the subtopic Einstein's equations and explanation. Albert Einstein proposed an explanation of the effect of the photoelectric effect using a concept used by Max Planck. In our last class, we are made to understand that Max Planck's theory of radiation. Max Planck also studied work on these photons of light ray that used to be emitted when an atom gains a lot of electron. So, Max Planck, during his research, made us to understand that the photon of the light ray that is being emitted, is given by E is same thing as HF, and our H stands for what we call the Planck constant, and our F stands for the frequency of the light ray. So, Albert Einstein worked on it, built an equation using the equations built by the Max Planck. He said that the total energy of the atom, the total energy of the light ray that is being emitted is the same based on the Albert Einstein's equation. The total energy of the photon of light is the same thing as the Planck constant multiplied by the frequency is the same thing as plus half of m v squared. So I think this is our fifth equation on this topic. So the term HF here refers to the total energy content of the single photon as being explained by Max Planck, while W here refers to the part of the energy W here is used to get the electrons free from the atoms and away from the metal surface, while the remaining one, which is half of mv squared, is the one that's used to give the electrons, that those emitted electrons, an additional energy. So work function, this W on the Albert Einstein equation, this W is refers to as what we call the work function. This W is what we call the work function, while half of mv squared refers to the amount of energy in which the electrons, in which the emitted electrons get and they begin to move. So our F, so the mathematical expression of this work function is the same thing as the Planck constant multiplied by F naught. Our F naught here refers to what we call the threshold frequency. Our F naught here refers to what we call the threshold frequency. So generally, the work function in which it refers to the amount of energy that is being the amount of energy that is required for an electron to be liberated from the surface of a metal. This amount of energy is not the same thing for the same element. For example, let's take copper. The amount of energy that is required to liberate an electron from a copper, from the surface of a copper metal, is not the same thing with the amount of energy that is required to emit electrons from the surface of iron. So, work function of an element differs from element to element. So, this is the mathematical expression of the work function. W stands for the work function, the same thing as HF naught. Our F naught stands for what we call the threshold frequency. So, what we mean by the threshold frequency here is the frequency of light which falls on a metal surface is sufficient to liberate an electron from that metal without giving that electron an additional kinetic energy. So that frequency of light in which when it falls on the metal surface is strong enough to liberate an electron from the surface of that metal. That frequency of light is what we call the threshold frequency. While what we mean by the work function, which has the symbol of W in Albert Einstein's equation, the work function J refers to the minimum amount of energy required to liberate an electron from the surface, from the metal surface. An electron, as I've told you, all the metals, they are made up of an electron. So for an electron to be lifted out of that metal, there must be what? A certain amount of energy that is required. So that amount of energy that is required to liberate that electrons from the surface of a metal without giving that metal an addition, without giving that electron an additional energy, we call that work function. So when we combine this equation, this is our equation 1.5, this is 1.6. When we combine these two equations, we are going to have HF is the same thing as HF naught plus half of mv squared. We are going to have something like this. Or we say that HF is the same thing as HF naught plus E. So this is our 1.7, this is 1.8. This is the total energy content of the photon. This is the work function, and this is the energy that the electrons gain and make it possible for the electrons to begin to move. So mathematically we can express it like this. Our kinetic energy will be represented by E. So we can make the kinetic energy E to be the subject of the formula. We have the kinetic energy E is stated as HF minus HF naught. So this equation, we call it the Einstein photoelectric equation. We call this equation the Einstein photoelectric equation. So Albert Einstein, generally, he built his equations based on the Max Planck's theory of radiation. Max Planck's theory of radiation suggested that when an electron in an atom gains an energy, it used what? When it gains an energy, it moves from a ground state to an excited state. Once the source of the energy ceases, it what? It jumps back. So when it jumps back to its original state, it used to emit a photon of light. And the photon of light, based on the Max Planck, the photon of light is given as E is same as HF. So Albert Einstein built his theory, his own equations, using the work done by Max Planck. He said that what? This total energy has a lot. It is made up of what? Part of the energy is being used to liberate an electron from the metal surface. And part of it is also used what? To make the electrons begin to what? To move with a particular energy or a velocity. So we call this Einstein photoelectric equation. So let's solve an example using this equation. So let's solve an example using the Einstein equation on the photoelectric effect. I have an example here, and it goes, a metal has a work function of 2.5 electron volts. Calculate 1, the threshold frequency, 2, the maximum energy of the liberated electrons when the metal is illuminated by a light of wavelength 3.5 times 10 to the power minus 5 centimeter. We are to take 1 electron volt to be 1.6 times 10 to the power minus 19 joules, and the speed of light C to be 3 times 10 to the power 8 meter per second, and the Planck constant H to be 6.6 times 10 to the power minus 34 joules seconds. So this is an example. Now the solution. The first question said that we have to calculate the threshold frequency. To calculate the threshold frequency, we use the relationship between the work function W and the threshold frequency F naught, which is being multiplied by a Planck constant H. So we have a mathematical expression like this. So from the question, the work function is given to be 2.5 electron volts, and each of the electron volts is 1.6. So we multiply 2.5 times 1.6 times 10 to the power minus 19 joules. We have to take the Planck constant H to be 6.6 times 10 to the power minus 34 joules. Our main aim is to obtain the threshold frequency F naught. So this is our work function. From here, bring this one here, thus substituting this into this equation. Then our H, look at the value for H here, 6.6 times 10 raised to the power minus 34 joules multiplied by the threshold frequency F naught. So you make the threshold frequency F naught to be the subject of the formula here. You have 2.5 times 1.6 times 10 to the power minus 19 joules divided by 6.6 times 10 to the power minus 34 joule seconds. You are going to have 6.06 times 10 to the power minus 19 hertz. That's the value of our threshold frequency. So we've solved the first question. Now the second one says to calculate the maximum energy of the liberated electrons. the maximum energy that the electrons that have been liberated have. Now, the maximum energy, they are being related to the work function by maximum energy E is sent in as the total energy of the photon minus the work function. Now, frequency and speed of light and wavelength, they are related by frequency is sent in as the speed of light C all over the wavelength of the light ray. Now, our wavelength from the equation, from the question, our wavelength is given to be 3.5 times 10 to the power minus 4 centimeter. Our wavelength is 3.5 times 10 to the power minus 5 centimeter. Now, if you convert this into meter, you have 3.5 times 10 to the power minus 17. Thus, you divide these values by 100. Thus, you convert the centimeter into meter. You divide this value by 100, you are going to have 3.5 times 10 to the power minus 7 meter. Now, our total energy of the maximum energy of the liberated electron E is sent in as, this is the Planck constant. This is the value for the Planck constant multiplied by C, which is the speed of light, divided by the wavelength, which is 3.5 times 10 to the power minus 7 meter, as I've just obtained it here, minus, this is the work function, this is the work function, so this is the minus, this is the work function, 2.5 times 1.6 times 10 to the power minus 19 joules. So, if you multiply 6.6 times 10 to the power minus 34, times 3, times 10 to the power 8, divided by 3.5 times 10 to the power minus 7, you are going to have 5.66 times 10 to the power minus 19. So you multiply 2.5 times 10 to times 1.6 times 10 to the power minus 9, we are going to have 4 times 10 to the power minus 9. So our total maximum energy obtained by the liberated electron is given is sent as 5.66 times 10 to the power minus 9 minus 4 times 10 to the power minus 19. So the maximum energy liberated by the electrons, if you subtract this, if you subtract 4 times 10 to the power minus 19 from 5.66 times 10 to the power minus 19, we are going to have 1.66 times 10 to the power minus 19. So that's the maximum energy of the liberated electrons when the metal is being liberated by a light of wavelength 3.5 times 10 to the power minus 5 centimeter. So I have an assignment for you. The first question says that what are the similarities and differences between the photoelectric effect and the thermionic emission? I think we've discussed thermionic emission too, somewhere in February. Then the second question says that you have to describe the mode of operation of the modern X-ray tube. Then the last one says you have to state the energy transformations which take place during the operation of the X-ray tube. So you do it and submit it to me through my email, masterdanmusa@gmail.com. Thank you. Have a nice day.